Why? Why make excuses? Why make excuses? People. We all know that murder, rape, commodification is evil. And it don't change how the victim been. No matter if the victim have feathers, fur or paws. No matter if the victims walk on two or four or have no feet. No matter if it's been a pig, a cow, a child or a human. Or a human child. No of the victims wants to be a victim. I want that you place yourself for one moment in their position. Imagine how it feel, how you feel, if you've been in their position. If somebody say that your life don't matter at all. If somebody say that your life is despicable, displaceable, and that you been just an object. That's how it's been to be a pig, a chicken, or a turkey on this planet. They don't be born free. They don't can be themselves. They don't can be how they want to be. They're being born is slavery. And if somebody is shocked by that term, slavery is a system wherein animals being commodified and socially oppressed and exploited for economic well-being. If you look to all the documentaries from the slavery with one open mind, with one not speciesistic mind, you can see that. If we not look it from the position of the victimizer. In the time of slavery, the most slave masters see the black slaves as objects. Just like some of you maybe see the animals as objects, when they're in reality living sentient creatures with a central nervous system that can feel pain, that can suffer. Please, think a moment on the suffering where you spare yourself the sight. No matter how kind or peaceful some animal be murdered, it still be murdered, or so like most people like to call it slaughter. The Nazis call it the murder of Jews euthanasia. It still be taking the life of an innocent being without his or her permission. And if you'll be shocked to hear some vegans say that cows been raped and other animals also been raped in the meat dairy industry. Rape is forcefully penetration. The animals been artificial inseminated, put a metal object and put in the vagina of the animals and inject them with bull semen or bear semen. Bear is one male pig. How can you ask for something when you're not being willing to extend it to other living beings? How can you ask for mercy if you're not being willing to extend this to living beings who have nothing intentionally harmed you once in their whole life? One pig, one turkey, or another animal, they have nothing harmed once a human intentional ever in the whole life for no good reason. So the least you can do is return the favor by becoming vegan and oppose discrimination and hatred by speciesism, the root of all discrimination. Before the people don't know what speciesism means, speciesism is the prejudice that humans being to be superior on animals. And that animals... therefore have to be enslaved and commodified. This is a bit like racism. Only then it compares to animals. The definition is first put up by the Jewish philosopher Isaac Bashevis-Singer. How escaped Nazi occupied Poland? In his words, when you look to the animals, how can be catched by humans? He'd always remembered him on the Holocaust. In his words, what do they know? All the leaders of the world, all the high priests, all the politicians, they have convinced themselves that man, humanity, is the crown of creation, and that all living beings be nearly to providing with food, for clothing or entertainment. In relation to them, all men are Nazis. For the animals, it is an eternal Treblinka. Humans, the most biggest scourge of this world, the only animal that be truly cruel, the only one that bring pain, knowing that it's costing pain, the only species that intentional dominates other living beings and humiliates them for pleasure. Awaken and start to oppose it all by one. What's also my video about why discrimination, nothing being apologized and destroyed. As long as we not eliminate the first form of hatred, the first form of bigotry, we not want to get a chance to destroy all other forms. If we go to discrimination, where it all goes to, is that one group thinks that he is more special and more really and more deserving of protection and more deserving of giving more rights than another. That's the essence of all forms of discrimination. Blacks have been discriminated by white, women been discriminated by men. Animals be discriminated by humans. They also all the times put animals in the position if they're being cruel by definition. When it be human that been actually the one that been intentional cruel, knowing that it cost pay, and knowing, and I also have power and the tools to do it otherwise. Let me be true. Let me be honest for a moment. If what being true also, if we can put a man on the moon and we can programmed on computer that can play chess, then with absolute surety we can bring an end to all execution chambers, also known as slaughterhouses, euthanasia centers, or how you want to call it, all places where people or animals be executed, exploited and commodified. Only the thing that we have to do as human species, if we claim to be humane and we want not be a cruel, hypocritical, lying creature, is to learn to think out of ourselves. Sorry for some maybe of the words have been hard to you. But I've been an activist, and sometimes when you've been an activist, you say things that nobody wants to hear. But you have to say it for the ones where you fight for. There have been also a lot of other problems with animal agriculture. This is the biggest cost of global warming. This is the biggest cost of environment destruction. Environment destruction and global warming. Climate change, or how you want to call it. It's been also the biggest cost of deforestation, diseases. But the people don't want to make money of it. They don't want to talk to you. Because that's how business work. Most businesses exist to make money. I don't give about morals or justice. They exist for this. Greed, corruption, and absolute power. That is the ones that rules the government. Not saving life or fighting crimes. Just being just social relationship talks. They don't give about your life. They don't give about my life. They give about this. And I only want you to talk the truth. Please. Do the right thing and go vegan. Eat beans, eat lentils, eat legumes, eat tofu. Eat sandham. I don't care. As long as you let the animals alone. They want not to be your victim. Just like you want to not to be their victim. They don't can speak for themselves. And therefore, you nothing will stop hearing my voice. Because that's what justice been. It don't stop when the oppressor, the exterminist, want it. It stop when the injustice stop. In revolutions, you have always two sides. You have the more radical part, and you have the politically correct part. Radical have in this time get a negative connotation. But what radical actually means is that you go to the root actually from a problem. Radical comes from the Latin word for root, and root means that you can actually go to the root of a problem. If you know what, if you understand it. And what radicals do is they don't circle around the problem, they go in the problem and clear it. That's what the true definition of radical mean. It is actually neutral from its origin. I would think about it. And think also about what I have today. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Subscribe to my channel. I do any day from the week at least one video, sometimes also on the weekends. Hit the bell and subscribe, and I see you next time. Peace begins on the dinner table.